Free agency has come, and it didn't disappoint. At the moment I'm making this video, the Lakers just got Dwight Howard back, signed Trevor Ariza, and most importantly, Carmelo Anthony. Yes, for the first time in LeBron's and Carmelo's career, they're going to play for the same team. What a time to be a basketball fan. The Nets and Lakers rosters are looking crazy, and I can't wait to see them going against each other next season. However, today, I would like to talk about another very important deal for the NBA. The Stephen Curry deal with the Golden State Warriors. Yes, Curry is going to sign a max extension, and obviously, the Golden State Warriors are ready to pay him a lot. And by a lot, I mean it. Curry's going to be the first player to ever sign two $200 million contracts. A blockbuster deal by any means. Today, we will talk about the reactions of people around the league to this groundbreaking deal. Also, I would really like to hear your opinions, as I'm very curious what you, my dear subscribers, NBA fans, and just passing by our viewers, think about the Dub's future. Now, grab some snacks, get yourself comfortable, and enjoy the video. But before that, smash that like button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already, and hit that notification bell to get updates on our latest NBA content. Let's keep rolling. We'll get straight to the point. And at the end of this video, I'll give you my honest opinion on Stephen Curry's max extension. Let's start with Twitter reactions. One of the first ones to react to this news was none other than Adrian Wojnarowski, an American sports columnist, reporter, and author. Woj confirmed the rumors, and from this point, the whole deal basically became official. Two-time MVP Steph Curry has agreed on a four-year, $215 million contract extension with the Golden State Warriors, making him the first player in history to sign two career $200 million-plus deals. His agent Jeff Austin at Octagon Basketball tells ESPN. The Bay Area reporter Grant Lifman also immediately responded to this tweet with the following. Expected at this point, but still feels nice to read it from Woj. One of the rules of the NBA is, it isn't official until Woj confirmed it, and it's true. But what about the expected part? Sure, Stephen Curry's name is synonymous with the Warriors, and there is literally not a single Warriors fan who doesn't like Curry. Although, there were people who actually thought that the idea of trading the best shooter in the history of the game is what the Dubs should do in order to save their future. Frankly, I don't quite think that those people were right. While every single NBA superstar has haters and doubters, I really think that Stephen Curry deserves all the money and hype he gets. This man is unique, one of a kind, and he proves it each year. We've all seen what great stats Curry put up this year. He's a game changer, and that's a fact. Now, let's take a look at Curry's reaction to this massive deal. It's dope to think about what all has transpired in the last 12 years, where we currently are, and what we're trying to do with this championship window that we have. Thinking about being in the Bay for another 5 years, taking me to 38, it checks all the boxes in terms of what I'm trying to do with my career, Curry told The Athletic's Marcus Thompson in an interview. Wholesome, isn't it? It's great to hear that a player of that caliber, who is still humble and passionate about playing for the team he was drafted to. His loyalty and the Warriors' appreciation of Curry's contribution to the team's history is the number one reason why this deal wasn't even a dilemma for the Dubs' general manager, Bob Myers. And I'm not the only one who thinks this way. A sports journalist, Sam Esfandiar, tweeted, "Gonna be super cool when Steph is the only superstar of this era to retire with one team. That's what a legacy looks like." Exactly. This is what we should call a legacy. I don't think that a player who switches teams are not as good as the loyal ones. It's just that it's really a rare thing in the modern league. Just look at Giannis Antetokounmpo. He stayed loyal to the team, and this year it paid off. Congratulations to the champ. However, there are always doubters, even for solid players like Stephen Curry. Kendrick, Mr. Annoy Stephen Curry Perkins, an American former professional basketball center and ESPN commentator, gave his two cents on the ESPN show First Take. In the latest episode, the analyst discusses Curry's max extension with the Golden State Warriors, and Perk was asked a question. How many titles do you see Steph Curry winning over the next 4 years? And he answered the following. You know what? I hate to say it right now, but to be honest with you, I don't see the Golden State Warriors bringing home another championship. And here's why. When I'm watching Bob Myers, and I love Bob Myers, he was my former agent before he took over the general manager job with the Golden State Warriors. He is not just being aggressive right now when it comes down to the offseason, and he's not making moves. I'm watching other teams around the NBA make moves. We watched the Lakers make moves yesterday. We watched the Lakers attack free agency. I mean, Rob Pelinka was in this bag like he got fries at the bottom. You watch the Denver Nuggets. They're trying to improve their roster. At the end of the day, we really don't know how Klay Thompson is going to come back. He's coming off two injuries, a torn ACL and Achilles. We don't know how much Draymond got left in the tank for him to be delivering in a great fashion, like the Draymond of old, when he used to be able to go out there and deliver 20-point nights and things of that nature. They, talking about the Denver Nuggets, Utah Jazz, Phoenix Suns, and Lakers, getting better. So sadly to say, I don't see the Warriors winning another championship. Well, this Perk's take is a thought-provoking one. I can't say that I agree with Perkins here, but to be honest, there is something to think about. While I do think that Stephen Curry's extension is a no-brainer, Perk has a point. The West is strengthening its positions. The Lakers are going all in, and rightfully so. The Nuggets are making very smart decisions in this free agency, and the Suns are ready to capitalize on Chris Paul's resigning with the team, while the Warriors are staying relatively silent. We need big-time moves in order to make things work in the years to come. It shouldn't necessarily be a deal with an all-star-level player, but it certainly should be something impactful. The fact that Kelly Oubre Jr. is leaving the team to sign with the Charlotte Hornets means that now the Warriors have even more gaps to fill this summer. Yes, the Golden State Warriors drafted well. I love the two new rookies, but we need a real reinforcement now. I would like still to give Bob Myers credit for our newly acquired rookies. The alliance of James Wiseman, Jordan Poole, Jonathan Kuminga, and Moses Moody is probably the best case scenario for the Warriors financially. They need veterans to join them at a price to help them to perform in the playoffs. The thing is that this kind of player will only often accept a deal to join a team that's already in contention. The Warriors aren't far away, but there are other teams that are closer. Hopefully, one good thing is that former Finals MVP Andre Iguodala is rejoining the Warriors, and he will be the perfect fit for the team. Overall, the fact that the Golden State Warriors signed a max extension with Stephen Curry wasn't unexpected by any means. The NBA world reacted to this pretty calmly, as we all know. Stephen Curry is a loyalist. Legacy over anything. And to be honest, the Golden State Warriors is still far from the worst team in the league. So it's a win-win deal for both. What do you think? Do you think Perk's take makes sense? Do you think that Stephen Curry deserves such a bag? Do you think that the Warriors should make moves this free agency? Tell us what you think in the comments down below, and once again, make sure to leave a like on this video and hit that subscribe button to catch up with the best NBA content. If you like this video, make sure to watch my other videos about recent NBA news. Thanks for watching.